Hey, what's up, Mr. Lynch?
Oh, hey, Jack. How's it going, man?
It's going good.
Good.
So what you doing?
I'm trying to plan this presentation about providing rigorous learning goals and performance skills, and I just cannot figure out how to make it entertaining. I mean, it's pretty dry stuff here in this Marzano book.
What about like a Star Wars theme, right? That'd be really cool.
Yeah, I don't know if that's really professional.
But... yeah, I guess.
Oh, well, I don't know.
That's right. Well, hey, I got into English, so...
all right. Hey, thanks for stopping by. Say hi, Jack.
No problem. Good luck with your stuff.
All right. Star Wars, huh? Oh, I don't know.
So anyway, Master, I'm not sure how I need to know what I need to know to become a Jedi.
Well, my young apprentices, you will acquire your own apprentices. It will be important to make clear to them their learning goals so that they will know the level of mastery that they need to achieve to become a Jedi themselves. Observe, young Jedis.
The way that I communicate my learning goals to my students is that every day I have my learning goals posted on the smart board for my students to see as they enter the room. They know to immediately get a tracking sheet out and to write their learning goals on the sheet. And then I will then reference each of their goals to a specific student learning scale. I will walk around the room and monitor what each student has indicated, and then I will ask as a group where they are on the learning scale. I will then have the student reflect that on their tracking sheet. We will reference these goals and their tracking sheet several times during the daily lesson, and then we will go back and refer to that at the end to see what they have learned. The list of learning goals that the students had today were they needed to list, explain, identify, and also analyze. And with these learning goals, that builds a progression of knowledge from simple to complex. With a specific lesson and many lessons in marketing, the information that they are learning is independent of each other. They need to grasp these concepts so that they can go to higher level thinking.
That we have for today's lesson. The first is list the three goals of a healthy economy. The second is explain how an economy is measured through economic indicators. And then lastly, you guys are going to be asked to identify and analyze the four key phases of the business cycle. If you can go ahead on your tracking sheet and just write these three goals down. Do not rate yourself yet. Just put on your tracking sheet three goals, please. On listing the three goals of a healthy economy, just on a blank sheet of paper that you have, I want you right now to write down and list the three goals of a healthy economy, because I want to see what you know right now.
Okay.
Miss Lynch, I need your lesson plans.
You don't need my lesson plans.
Yeah, I don't need your lesson plans.
So, Master, how do I know how well I need to know the subject?
Well, as you provide learning goals, it's also important to teach your young apprentices the level to which they need to achieve mastery. Otherwise, they will never become generals.
The way that I communicate learning goals to my students each day is by utilizing this board in the back of the classroom. And the board is separated into three sections. The first section of the board says, what am I responsible for learning today? This indicates that it is the student's responsibility to take ownership for their learning, and that's why I phrase it in a question. It is inferred, the phrase the students will understand or students will be able to do based on answering that question. The second is where I would list the instructional strategies or the learning activities under the How Will I Learn It section. That is what students will do during the class period to help them learn or to master the content that we will be covering. And then finally, how will I demonstrate what I learned? This is where I will communicate to the students what they're going to be expected to do to show what they know and to demonstrate their mastery of the content. So on this particular day, the learning targets for the day were to identify one educational psychologist and name his or her theory, and also to explain the theory and analyze how that theory has impacted education. And I put in parentheses, why is this important knowledge for educators? So because I teach a teaching professions program, we have already talked about Bloom's taxonomy and discussed the Bloom's verbs and how they relate to rigor. So I underline the Bloom's verbs as I write the goals, because we have further discussions about the level of rigor indicated in the learning goals. For each, then, if further explanation is needed to put it into student-friendly language, we do that as a group, and possibly I write it up there in parentheses as well. So explain the theory and analyze how that theory has impacted education may sound complicated, but ultimately they really need to know, why is this theory important knowledge for educators? What does that matter to them? For this particular assignment, the instructional strategies or the learning activities were that students worked with a group and researched a specific educational psychologist, and then each of those groups presented that theory and that psychologist to the class. And then we had a rubric that went along with the specifics required for that presentation, which is indicated up here in the How Will I Learn It section, because it would not be logical to put everything on the rubric on the board each day. The other linkage is the scale for the learning targets. For some specific learning targets, I have it scaled based on the specific learning target. Otherwise, the scale really indicates the level of rigor that they're expected to master in regards to the teaching professions program. Four, or the highest level of mastery for each learning target, says, I have a strong understanding of the objective and can thoroughly write about it in an essay. So as I explain it to students, if this is a topic that if I put the name Eric Erickson on the board and listed the theory, would they be able to write a full-length essay about what that theory is, explain it, and also indicate why that would be important for a teacher to understand? If they could do that, that's a four. And ultimately, in their portfolios for the teaching professions program, that's what they're expected to do. Three is that they understand the concept, they understand how to use it in class, but may not feel comfortable writing about it on their own, meaning they need more practice to achieve full mastery. A two is, I have some understanding of the objective, but further explanation or practice is required before I'm comfortable with it. So again, they have a general understanding of the objective, but at the same time, they require more practice, additional information to move to the next level. And then a one is that they do not understand the learning objective and that they could not use that information. I think at the beginning, because most of the information that we talk about in teaching professions is brand new to our students, most students definitely end up in the number one or number two category as we scale the learning target at the beginning of the day. And then we can go back to this scale and refer to it at the middle and possibly also at the end of a lesson or at a unit at different points to indicate how well the students are mastering the content and to what level. And this also helps inform my practice so far as the types of instructional strategies and learning activities that I use to maximize efficiency in helping students get to the threes and the four levels so that they're prepared to write the portfolio this senior year.
All right, everyone, welcome. I'm so glad to see your smiling faces just like every day, just because there's a camera in the back of the room. Do not act awkward like I am right now. Here's what we're going to do. As with every day, we need to find a learning target for the day. So would you please stand up? All right, we're going to turn a man towards the learning target. Everybody take a look. Put your eyeballs on the section of the board that says, what am I responsible for learning today? The first thing is, you are going to identify a key educational psychologist and link them to their major theory. So what does that identify word mean? You are going to, if their name is on a paper, know who they are, and you are going to know the name of the theory that is associated with them. The next learning target for the day is explain each theory and analyze how that theory has impacted education. So as it says, explain and analyze, what that means is, with that theory, what does that matter to teachers? Why do teachers need to know that educational theory? Everybody got it?
Yeah.
All right, sit down. So the theorist that we are going to talk about today is going to be Erik Erikson. So give me a show of hands on our scale of 1 to 4. Could you, if his name was on a paper, identify who that is and say what his theory is, and then explain that theory and why it's important to teachers? Scale of 1 to 4. 1 being, I could not do that at all. 4 is, yes, I can write a whole essay that is well developed about that topic. All right, give me a show of hands. Some people must have taken AP Psych because you've heard of Erik Erikson. All right. Most of you not. That's good. By the end of class, hopefully, we will move that forward.